Hi, this video was requested by a violin fanatic. This is Introduction in Rondo Capriccioso by Camille Saint-Saëns. And let me just demonstrate how I open this piece, and then I will talk about it afterwards. So. Okay, that wasn't too bad for a first run today. Let's talk about the beginning then. There's a definite phrase here where there's four pieces to that very first phrase. So, can you count those four pieces? Let me show you which ones they are. So here's the first piece. Second piece. Third piece, and last piece. Now each of those pieces makes up this first opening phrase. And let's look at the phrase that follows immediately after. Okay, do you hear those four pieces again? Real quick. That's the first one. And that's the second one. Third, and then here's the last. Okay, so two phrases, and these are two phrases that are completely related. So the first one is kind of introducing the idea of this opening. Kind of like, you know, if I were to think of a story just spontaneously, it's like saying, you know, I could think of something silly, but the kid's sitting there going, Mom, can I have a cookie from that cookie jar? Okay. They look really tasty. Can I just please have one? And then maybe the second phrase is elaborating on the reason why he should get a cookie. I mean, they're glazed, they have all this sugar on it. And besides, I'm really hungry right now. My tummy's hurting. And then maybe it gives him the puppy eyes. Okay, and then this first phrase that we just covered with the four pieces in the very beginning, it comes back. Except the difference now is that you're hitting a C sharp instead of a C. And maybe this part in the story that I'm making up right now as we speak is where the kid goes, oh, but you don't have to give me a cookie. I mean, so something like that, where he's kind of a little pouty. I didn't want one anyway. But if you give me one, then I'll leave you alone. Okay, and then the rest of the story right here. Maybe he's trying to get to the cookie jar and the mom is trying to block him. And mom says, no. And the kid goes, aww. Now this time, the second time, the... Now he's going to be really sneaky. He's going to go underneath the chair, underneath the table even, out of sight from the mom. And what does he run into? The dad. And maybe here, the dad's like, you know, let me tell you a story about when I was little having a cookie. I mean, it was the best tasting thing ever. And it filled me with a lot of energy. And then this little run here could be him having a sugar rush. He says, but there was a consequence. And what was that consequence? Let me tell you. So, that obviously is a story that I just barely came up with. I had no idea that was the story that was going to come out. But the real trick here is that each time that you play this piece, you're probably going to think of something new as far as how to interpret that opening. So whatever it applies to you, make sure that it has a beginning and an end to the story, as well as a very concrete middle. So you can follow the story as I showed you or explained to you this time, that you can follow a definite storyline. And if you do that, then the music's going to make a heck of a lot more sense to you when you play it. And one of the tricks that I've learned as a professional violinist is that the best performances that I have are the ones where I know the story behind this piece. And it's not necessarily the story that Camille Saint-Saëns had in his mind. It's just a story that I have in my mind as a performer during the time that I'm playing. Okay, so let's keep going. Let me just talk a little bit about this next part. Each time that you play this, these little, and then the last one, each of those has to be different. And so the way that I'm doing it is the very first two of those sharp notes, these, I'm doing them very decisively the first time. And then the second time, a little bit more legato and a little bit wider vibrato. And the last one I'm doing a little bit even more vibrato and more legato and less edgy, less sharp. Sharp meaning the articulation that you put on it. So. Now I'm leading everything to the very end. So this whole entire phrase starting from, I'm leading all the way to that end of the phrase. So when you listen to it, and I don't know if this is coming through in the camera, but I'm actually crescendoing a little bit, leading to the end of that phrase. So, lead, lead, lead. And the phrase doesn't actually end, that piece of the phrase doesn't actually end until that last bit of notes.